Hi everyone! In this video, I'm going to share with you 5 principles of Montessori that every parent should know. Now, I understand it must be confusing for many parents, you know, what Montessori is about, and I hope these 5 principles will help you. Now, the first principle is hands-on learning. Montessori discovered that children love to move around. They can hardly keep still. So instead of forcing them to sit, you know, and having a teacher to tell them what to do, how to do, and explain concepts, what she did was she designed this very specific set of materials for them to work with. And, you know, they love it, because if you enter a Montessori environment, you see all the materials laid out and children are able to explore with them and learn. So in a Montessori classroom, instead of learning through memorization or through worksheets, what the children do is they work with the materials to learn. So a child in a Montessori classroom will learn addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, all through working with materials. And this is wonderful because they get to learn much more than the teacher can actually explain to them. And the learning, you know, it sets their foundation because they actually understand. They don't do math the abstract way. They do it, they learn it the concrete way, which gives them that full understanding. And there is also a lot of brain research today that, you know, proves the connection between the hand and the mind. So it's like there's a connection between movement and cognition. Now, the second principle is vertical age grouping. Now, authentic Montessori schools, they follow this vertical age grouping. What does this mean? It means that if you go to a Montessori school, in a classroom, you will find that children are divided into 3-year groups, such as, you know, 3 to 6 years and 6 to 9 years, etc. Why? Because we believe, in Montessori, we believe that children learn best from one another, from each other, and a three-year-old will look up to the 6-year-old. They learn through observing. They do a lot of learning through observing the older ones work with the material. And the older ones, when they have learned, they see a younger one struggling with something, they go and help the younger one. It gives them that opportunity to teach the younger ones. And as they teach, that reinforces their learning. It also helps them to practice their leadership skills. Yeah. Next one is holistic learning. Now, in a Montessori and in Montessori approach, we focus on the child as a whole. We just don't focus on academics. Academics is, yes, it's very important, and we do focus on that as well. But in addition to that, you know, in addition to math, language, and science, children also learn practical skills in life. Now, this practical activities in a classroom that helps the children to become independent and responsible. In addition to that, they also learn sensorial. There's a sensorial activity section. Now, what happens is that children learn basically through their senses. And Maria Montessori has discovered that, yes, this is how they learn, through all their 5 senses. So to refine their senses, this sensorial activity area has been set. While working with the materials, children, you know, start to, they become very creative, they develop all the 5 senses, and they learn to become very independent with the practical life activities. And this then helps them to feel good about themselves. It increases their self-confidence and their self-esteem. Yeah. So materials in the sensorial area are very attractive, and they also allow a lot for children's creativity. They can combine the materials to create so many different things. The next principle is prepared environment. Now, this is a distinct feature of a Montessori method. If you enter a Montessori classroom, you will immediately know whether it's authentic or not from the way they have laid out the environment. You will see 5 different areas: practical life, sensorial, math, language, and science and culture. And you will also see that all these materials are laid out beautifully in a lovely order with shelves, so it's accessible to children. They are all low shelves, and children are allowed to explore these materials. The materials are also laid out in an order from simple to complex, and taking them also from concrete to abstract. So it's a very perfectly laid out order that, you know, children are able to then work with the material, and then it leads on to the next learning and to the next learning. And also in the Montessori classroom, you will see that everything has a place and everything is in its place. And there's a certain sense of order that helps the children to feel good in the classroom, because they know when they want to work on a particular material, they know where exactly it is. The next principle is freedom within limits. Now, in a Montessori classroom, children are given the freedom, but with limitations. It's not just the freedom to do whatever they want. They have all this freedom, but there is a limit to it. That's why when you enter a Montessori classroom, you will see children moving around. However, with all that, there is still no chaos in the classroom. You see the children working with the materials, but you won't see the materials all misused or abused and thrown out of their thing. It always goes back into place. Now, why is this so? It's all because of this freedom. The freedom is given to the child to choose any material that they like. And there is also a rule in place that, yes, you can use these materials, but once you have finished using, you have to place it back so others can use it. Similarly, I mean, the children are able to work, move around in the classroom, yeah? And there is also a ground rule in place for that. Yes, you can move around, you can, you know, you don't have to sit still, but you can't run, or you can't, you have to be very careful, you have to be aware. There's a spatial awareness that, you know, that is taught to them also while they are moving around. So that's why you don't see any chaos in the classroom. Similarly, they have the freedom, you know, they have the freedom to move around, like I mentioned. They have the freedom to choose the materials that they want to work with. They have the freedom to choose whether they want to work with a material on the table, or they want to take it to the floor and work with the material. They have the freedom to work with the material as long as they want to. So there is no one telling them, enough now, you know, you've done enough of language, now you have to do mathematics, nothing like that. They have the freedom to work with it as long as they want to. So this freedom, there are various other freedom, and all this freedom comes within limits. And that is what makes Montessori very successful, and what makes the children very calm, because with the freedom that we give them, we also entrust them the responsibility to use the freedom wisely. Of course, there's a way of how we do all these things, and it works, and it's just magical. So if you would like to, if you have any questions or would like to know more about anything about Montessori, do let us know. I hope you've enjoyed learning about the five principles of Montessori. And if you have any questions, feel free to post them, and I'll be happy to answer them for you. Bye for now.